calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength.
Our hands, okay? You do everything that I do, kind of like follow the leader, okay? So first, I want you to put your hands up, and see how far you can stretch those fingers out. Is that good? Yeah? Can you wiggle your fingers? Can you point one finger up? Good. Can you clap? How about snap your fingers? Snapping fingers can be hard. Good try. Can you make a duck? Okay, so let me show you how to make a duck. So if you put your two hands, your fingers like this, and then take that finger to make his eye. Quack, 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 quack. That's kind of fun, isn't it? Do you know some people, they can't hear, so they talk with their hands. And let's see. This is how you say, I love you, with your hands. So you can have two fingers down, two fingers up, and one out to make kind of the L of I love you. It's a good thing to learn, isn't it? Mm-hmm. types of things have you done with your hands today? Did they help you eat? Maybe. Did you play a game or throw a ball with your hands? That's fun. Maybe you drew a picture and you used your hands to do that. Your hands can show people how much you love them. Maybe you can pet a puppy with your hands or give a hug and you use your hands to squeeze them. Maybe someone falls down and you reach your hand out and you help them get up using your hands. That's great. You know, our Heavenly Father uses His hands to work in our lives. He wants to protect us and bless us. Let me read you something from the Old Testament. Isaiah 41:10 says, "Don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be discouraged, for I am your God. I will strengthen and help you. I will hold you up with my victorious right hand." Wow. You know, that verse tells us that God watches over us and He guides us. So we don't have to be afraid. We just have to let Him do it. I've got a little activity you can do with your family to kind of illustrate how God guides us with His hands. So everyone who's going to be involved needs a plate. And if you have a paper plate, it works a little bit better. Or if you don't have a plate, a piece of paper would work. And you will also need a marker. Okay? So you will be the drawer. And we also need one person who will be the person giving instructions. You're going to take your plate and you're going to put it on your head. Kind of like a hat, just like that. Woo! Mine didn't stay up there, did it? All right, so hold your plate on your head, and you're going to put your marker like this to be ready to draw. Now, here's the rules. You cannot take that plate off your head and look at it until we're finished. Okay? Deal? Good. So, you're all ready to draw. And the instruction person is going to give these instructions. And I'm going to see if I can give instructions and draw. So first they're going to say, "Can you draw a sun on your plate?" "And can you draw a house?" "And can you put a window in your house and a door?" "And can you draw a flower?" Maybe a couple of flowers. "And a big old tree right in front of the house." Okay, so when you do that, you can take your plate off your head and look at your picture. Mine doesn't look like any of those things, does it? Well, that's pretty bad. Okay, so you can put that plate aside. And this time, I want you to get in pairs so that you have a partner. One of you will be the drawer, and one of you will be the guiding hands. So the drawer will get a new plate, put it on their head, have their marker ready to draw, and the partner will come behind them, and they will see what's being drawn on the plate, and they will guide the drawer's hands. And drawers, you have to let them help you. And guiders, you have to help your drawers make a great picture. So with that up there, your helper, your drawer all ready, person giving the instructions will say the same things. Can you draw a sun? Can you draw a house? Put a window and a door in your house? Draw some flowers in front of it and a big tree next to it. When you're done, you take your plate off your head and see how well you did helping with the help. I'm going to guess that you've done a lot better because you've had someone helping you. want to talk about which way to draw the picture was easier and which way was more effective, which one made a better picture. You might want to talk about why was it difficult to draw when you didn't have any help. You know, once you see that, you'll see that it's sometimes hard to let someone else have control. God is the ultimate creator. He made this whole earth. He made us. We can trust him to be our helper and to guide our lives. If we try to do everything on our own without God, things can get messy, like my drawing. God's hands are always reaching out to us. He loves us. He cares for us. He's our Father. And he'll pick us up when we're feeling sad, and when we're doing the right thing, he claps for us. And when we're sad, he will wipe away our tears. And he'll point out the way we need to go. We just have to follow it. Why don't we pray? Lord God, thank you so much for loving us. Thank you for protecting us and guiding us so that we don't ever have to be afraid. Help us to let you show us what we need to do. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, I look forward to seeing your messy picture as well as your partner picture. And I hope you have a great week, and I'll see you soon. Bye.